show you how to make enemies at Lootsplode in Borderlands 2. Well, yeah, let's just get right into it. What you're gonna want to do is, of course, have the Borderlands 2 cheat compilation by Technojacker. Enable it. Now it's enabled. Look at that. You want to go down here to your scripts, go to Lua Script Enablers, and then go down here to Lootsploder Advanced. Now this is where the magic happens. So you want to go to Guns and Gear. Oh yeah, first thing, sometimes you'll get these little question marks, so make sure the game's unpaused and then Alt-Tab back out. And then select the option again, and there we go. I'm going to try changing them all to 4. That's probably going to cause pretty big things. Change it to any number you want. I would just recommend staying within 4, because your game will crash. I've tried setting them all to 10, and the game crashed. And then you want to select white, green, blue, purple, and E-Tech loot, and you're going to set all of the... You're going to set odds MP and amount P to 0. Because that makes it to where no whites, no greens, no blues, no purples, and no E-Techs will drop. Only legendaries. And finally, once you get to legendary pearl loot, you're going to want to change the odds to 0.1 and the amount to 4. Now, no, it doesn't make sense. Changing the odds to 0.1, that's kind of dumb. Well, the way it works is, I think the lower the number, the higher the odds for it to happen is, because if you noticed, the odds were on 3 for legendaries and everything else, it's 1. Alright, and then you want to go to item rarity drop mod, drop modifier. Wait for it to scan the thingamabobs. Then you want to select legendaries 1,000 times more likely under rarity wave presets. Go to item drop rates. And the cool thing is you can do this with your friends. So if you got 2 players, 3 players, you want to change the drop rates depending on, the amount of players. So yeah, you can do it with friends. It's pretty cool. And I think that's it. Yeah. After that, you just want to go up here and finally turn on Lootsploder. And that's it. That's all you gotta do. Alright, now we're back in the game. Hopefully when I shoot something, the game won't crash. But they will probably blow up into a large pile of legendaries. Let's see it.